Thank you. There are bears around here.
Thank you.
thought you were shot.
I got better.
The bitch is bit.
Oh, you're gonna shoot me again? That worked so well for you last time.
Yeah. Hey. You know, I might not have enough silver to kill you, but I could sure make you suffer.
This isn't gonna be too pleasant for you, I promise you that.
This is my knife. No, please. Please.
Nobody takes my knife.
You stabbed me!
You're leaking red like a juice box.
Oh, please, you can help me.
No, man, you're bleeding out. The only thing I can do is put you out of your misery. Humane-like.
Laura! Oh no, you've been bit!
Pick on someone your own size.
Travis! Laura? Oh, easy. Easy.
What the fuck happened to you?
Oh, you know, nothing out of the ordinary.
Oh, Ryan!
Oh, how bad is it?
I'm so sorry.
That bad, huh?
I keep trying to fix it. Whatever this is, people keep getting hurt. First Max, now you.
It's not your fault. I didn't have to come here.
I shouldn't have let you come.
You're not the boss of me. Sorry.
It's okay.
Am I dying?
You've lost a lot of blood.
But it'll heal though, right?
Wait. Maybe it will.
What?
Ryan, if you let me bite you...
What?
If you let me bite you, it means you'll be infected, which means...
Which means it will heal.
Yeah. But it also means...
Yeah. Yeah, I got it, Big Bad Wolf.
Yeah. Ryan, I don't have much time. I can feel it, like it's fighting to get out. If you let me bite you and you heal, then...
Then I have to kill Chris.
It's not killing Chris, it's killing a werewolf. It's saving your own life. And mine. And Max's and your friends, too.
Let you bite me and live to kill Chris Hackett or bleed out and die.
Pretty much, yeah. It's your call for now. So are we doing this or no?
Do it.
Okay.
Nice and tender for you.
Got it.
This guy's never thrown anything out, huh?
So, do you want to give me some direction on what we're looking for specifically?
Well, most of these cars look like they've already been stripped for parts. Just empty frames and chassis, which doesn't help us much.
Okay, so we're looking for engines?
Well, anything relatively intact.
Got it. Looks like we got our work cut out for us, huh?
Try not to make too much noise.
Oh, right. Anything by you?
Not yet. Keep looking.
In a documentary.
No! Shut up. Come on, let's go.
These sons of bitches had it all planned out. Who's T? Looks like these guys were cooking the books a little.
Dodgy.
You said it. Sorry, that was scary. That's so annoying.
We are being hunted by literal monsters, and this is what bothers you?
Yeah, both are bad. Look.
So, you ever operated a crane before?
I actually used to be pretty good at the claw game at my local arcade. The kids used to call me the grabber.
No, uh-uh.
Oh, I hear that, yeah.
Look, why don't you see if you can lower it down so I can take a look under the hood?
Do you mind if I take a little protection?
I kind of feel like I'm more exposed down here.
Yeah, but, you know, you're tougher.
Uh-huh.
Come on.
Anything comes at us, I'll take him out. I'm a better shot anyway.
Look, I really don't want to go up there unarmed. Oh, very funny.
Look, I'm not giving you a weapon in your state. End of discussion.
Looks like somebody's mom never taught them how to clean up after themselves. Okay, let's see what we're working with. All right, not too complicated. Welcome back, grabber.
Now you're falling away with you.
What the hell is going on?
My bad.
All right, here goes nothing.
You did it!
Yeah. I think I found my calling.
About time! Well, maybe we can see if we can try and get this thing running. Score!
Something coming!
What?
Hide!
Dylan, thank you. You actually saved my life. For realsies.
Yeah, you know, no sweat. I just can't wait to see who they choose.
What?
To play me in the movie about how brave I am.
Don't push it.
Okay. So, so much for our brilliant escape plan.
Okay, back to the lodge.
Are you nuts?
Better than being out in the open. Come on.
Go be a counselor at summer camp, Abby. You'll learn how to interact with people better, and you'll have loads of fun and make friends for life. I'm so sick of people telling me. What do I do now? Hello? Is anyone there? Why the lights went out. The hunter must have come this way before he attacked us upstairs.
Getting through there in a hurry. Man, this place is huge.
Might need to rest a bit.
You'll feel better soon.
Cool.
I'm feeling pretty good, actually.
What are you doing? Stop it.
Do you smell that?
No.
Never mind. Let's just find another way down. A way to Chris Hackett.
Or just a way out, maybe. I'm done being chased and stabbed.
Sure. And another way out. Fine. Watch your step.
Yep. What was that?
I think we found Chris Hackett. Son of a bitch.
Thanks for not killing me.
Yeah, likewise.
So, what now? Everyone's back to normal?
What? Oh. You think this is over? This isn't over.
I don't understand. Chris is dead.
Huh. Well, Chris wasn't the first.
That's not possible.
Caleb. Kaylee. The girl you killed? Her brother.
What?
Caleb bit Chris and Kaylee. Chris was just trying to protect him. He was a good man, my brother.
Well, then who bit Caleb?
Silas. They've been tracking him for years. He's a... gypsy, transient. He'd been long gone from the area, but we hoped he'd come back so we could end this. Anyway, there's sightings up and down the coast. A feral albino child, giant white wolf.
White wolf?
What? What'd you say? Where?
Where'd you see it?
Hey, let him go!
At the cabins earlier tonight.
Okay. Okay. Okay, it makes sense. It all makes sense. He must have been back for months, and he's what ran you off the road 2 months ago. Help me. Help me. We can still save Caleb. We can still save what's left of my family. We can help those who are still alive.
Why the hell should I trust you?
I'm not asking you to trust me. I'm telling you we can end this. We kill Silas. Everyone gets better. Everyone who's still alive, anyway.
Okay, so where would we even find him?
I know exactly where to find him.
Okay, let's go.
Okay.
This doesn't mean I forgive you for what you did to me.
I understand.
Can someone please get me some fucking clothes?
You had your chance. You had your chance to wipe out that wretched family, and you failed. Doesn't matter. There's still time. We can still come out on top. Past is the past. Let's just look to the future, shall we? The sun. The vitality of a new day. There's still time to wake up to the warmth of a night survived. Your choices, your actions, your very life hangs in the balance. It's up to you to find your path in the darkness and see the sun rise once again. The Hierophant. Where did you find this? Where did you find it? This shouldn't be here. He's been through enough pain. No. My poor boy. You see what that did to us? No. What have they done? What have they done?
Oh,
Mommy's coming, Silas. Mommy's coming, Silas! 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 No. My poor boy. You see what they did to us? How they hurt us. He's out there still, all alone. Each full moon, they hunt him, armed with silver, trying to put an end to a curse they inflicted upon themselves when they set my show ablaze 6 years ago. Stupid children. Little Silas. My little white wolf. He must be protected. You must not follow this path. Do you understand? Remember how I've helped you all this time. Remember how much I've done for you. Where the hell are my clothes? You gotta be kidding me. Okay. Gotta find Laura. Just gone to the Harbinger Motel.
Oh, fuck!
Oh, no. She must have come back.
Table, help me.
Okay. Well, can't get much worse than it already is, right? Great. Just like the cartoons.
It's been off and on all night. Gives us a little time.
How do you figure?
They don't like water, remember?
Right. Oh, we should have just been swimming in the lake all night.
And die of hypothermia? No.
All right, well, we're good now.
Night's not over yet. These fuckers know we're in here, and they're coming back first chance they get.
Great news, okay.
All right, we gotta get a vantage point. nice to put a name to a big, mean face. So what, you're like Mr. H's brother, I guess?
Who?
The big dude from earlier, when you and Ryan went to the radio hut. Mr. H's brother, I guess?
Right, right.
Poor Ian. Some camp mascot to kick it before camp starts. Hindsight. Sounds about right.
We have a camp mascot?
Well, no, we did. But you didn't hear?
Hear what?
He died before we got to camp.
Bummer.
Where have I seen this emblem before?
What is it?
A ring with a crest on it.
Oh, very fancy. You can never pull it off. Sorry.
I remember Mr. H's cheesy-ass announcements. Whoa.
Careful with that. That's a camp relic.
Relax. It's dead anyway.
Ah. R.I.P. megaphone.
This trail cam footage. It's like they're looking for something.
Yeah, in Chris's surveillance room, he's storing all the footage. I think you might be right.
How long has this guy been here?
A long time ago. Long enough ago that it was okay to have an oil painting made of yourself.
I kind of want an oil painting of me now.
Every dusk and dawn all through the summer. What doesn't kill you will make you stronger. We're here to lead the way. Fuck mates for life, we're proud to say. Shout it Stroud and shout it loud. We're hacketeers. 2 months and you never learn the words? Showtime, motherfuckers.
Come on, Abby. Keep it together. Not long till morning. What was that?
Here!
So what exactly happened 6 years ago?
There was a fire that wiped out dozens of people, and now there's werewolves and a ghost that roams the woods looking for her lost baby boy. Which I've just put together is Silas. Oh shit.
It's a long story.
No, it's not. There was a fire. Silas the wolf boy escaped, bit a bunch of your family. You failed to stop him.
Burn.
What happened in the past doesn't matter right now.
It kind of does, actually. We need to know what we're up against, at least.
What we're up against is a feral boy turned werewolf for the last 6 years has avoided being found. No matter what we did. Every full moon we were out there looking. Every single one. Now the son of a bitch is finally here. So what we're up against is my only chance to end this thing for good.
So how do you even know where he is? How the hell are we gonna find him just driving down the middle of the road?
It's been an interesting night, wouldn't you agree? The cycle continues, for some at least. I have to admit, you've disappointed me, but not as much as you could have done. We're bonded now, you and I. And though the full moon will come again and the curse remains, this night is over. Don't worry. I'll never forget what you did here. But don't you dare ever step foot in Hackett's quarry again. If I see you poking your nose where it doesn't belong, I will never stop haunting you. Wherever you go, I'll be right behind you. The breath on your neck, always just out of sight. If you ever come back, I will haunt you until the day you die.
bodies pile up after summer camp massacre. What do you make of that, Anton?
Kind of a gross way to put it, no? Why make a pile?
I think it's metaphorical. At least, I hope it's metaphorical.
I thought we'd done the whole Hackett's Quarry thing.
Not this Hackett's Quarry thing.
What was this, like 3 months ago? Old news, dude.
Anton, introductions first. We are Bizarre Yet Bonafide, the podcast of the paranormal. I'm Great.
I'm Anton.
And together, we explore the possibility of supernatural involvement in real-life, everyday occurrences.
And that's exactly what they are, real-life, everyday occurrences.
With a shadow of spiritual, supernatural occurrences.
No.
Okay, so I hope you've got hat insurance, Anton, because I'm about to blow your mind!
Did you just ask if I had hat insurance?
Yes. It's responsible to insure those things which mean the most to you.
A hat?
Yes.
Okay, I know where your priorities lie. Go on.
Anyway, there actually is a real reason that we're coming back to Hackett's Quarry. There've been some developments, and I've sourced some information.
I remain skeptical, but I'm all ears. Under my hat.
I was hoping you'd say that.
Oh God, why? Why are you smiling? Stop it, I hate it.
Why? I had braces. I have to make use of them sometimes.
You do have very pretty teeth.
Thank you. That's something that a lot of podcast listeners might not know about me. So, it just so happens I've got someone on the inside. So today's episode is going to have a bit of a show and tell vibe to it.
Who do you know on the inside? The inside of where?
What?
You know someone on the inside?
Don't we all have someone on the inside? You know, an inner critic that says, stop doing a podcast. No one's listening.
You should listen to that voice, Grace.
Okay, well, what I really meant is, let's call it an anonymous donation. You know, we're not the only ones who flagged this as a bizarre situation. Someone actually reached out to us. They sent us a package.
Did you? You didn't open it. I don't trust anyone who listens to this show.
Oh, I couldn't wait to open it. Surprise!
Anonymous donation?
Okay, you've always promised me since day one of this podcast that